There is a place where the lost embers go. As their light begins to fade, Ember ran, because standing still made them feel helpless. The wall glistened. The painting showed embers on a sacred journey. Ember felt so afraid and alone that it was a relief to find someone to talk to. Ember froze, almost too frightened to look away, when they noticed a small satchel. Felt heavy. Ember looked inside. The statue shone brightly in the light. There was a symbol on the floor. Ember noticed something wrong. There was a round space where something used to fit. To Ember's delight, the golden statue slid perfectly into place. Ember left, feeling sorry for the stranger now alone in the dark. The stairway opened into a dark forest. Ember could feel fear taking over. They'd washed up alone, somewhere very unfamiliar. Ember felt like they were being watched. As Ember approached, the flame seemed to grow. With a feeling like falling, the forest had slipped away. Ember felt lost in darkness and ruin. The caged flame stoked new hope in Ember. Hope was almost within reach. The flame spoke and Ember listened. The flame lingered ahead. Was it trying to escape? Or leading the way? Campfire flickered into life. The ghost spoke. Hope I will warm them until they choose to move on. Ember looked to the ghost for answers. This is a place between to travel through as your light fades. But none have passed on in a long time. The Forest King now holds us here, and those who linger will turn forlorn. Again, that word, forlorn. The forlorn are those who lost their way. If you find them, send them to me and I will guide them. I am just a guide along the way to fan the flame. So many lost embers have I seen. More than Ember thought of those they loved, those they'd left behind. The Forest King, what the campfire will light the way. Find those who are lost. Bring embers to the fire. There are others lost. Find them and I will guide them. Travel wisely. Return if you have lost your way. The crow held its shining trophy tight. The broken net hung ominously around the skeleton's neck. The stranger shivered in the cold. They'd moved through such dark places. They lay down and closed their eyes. Was a distant memory stolen by the passing miles. stranger blinked at Ember. Is it morning already? How long have I been asleep? The stranger blinked at Ember. Is it morning already? How long have I been asleep? The worm looked helpless, with no way to escape. As Ember picked it up, the worm let out a little yelp. The stranger had been forgotten. They tried to follow as best they could. But no one heard them when they fell behind. The stranger looked at Ember with surprise. Someone came back for me. Thank you. The stranger had blazed their own path. Created their own rock, their own islands. Thank you. They did not need Ember's kindness. But still, Ember stayed. Building a bridge, should it ever be needed. The stranger met Ember's eyes. The two shared a moment of silence. The stranger was trapped, caught in a maze. It was hard to make sense of this place. The trail just kept on closing. The stranger's voice was hoarse. I just need some time, I think, to see things clearly. The fisherman murmured quietly between sorrowful breaths. The fisherman felt so useless. His former joys were hollow. Sitting out there every day by the pond, only the dark water to hear him talk. In that darkness, a glimmer flickered. A thought beating like a drum. A thought that went round and round. It all started with a frog. Every day by the pond, a constant reminder. For a brief moment, the fisherman struggled to speak. He looked at Ember, hopeful. The fisherman spoke softly. Saw him grow from a tadpole. We were friends of us, spent every day side by side. So much better at fishing than me, that frog catches them before I can bait them. Oh, it makes me feel useless some days, the fisherman sighed. I've wasted so much. The old man looked carefully at the pond, at their rod. Well, listen to me here. It helps though, telling someone. Thank you, Ember. If you need help catching anything, you just ask. The frog stared at Ember, its belly rumbling. This was not how Ember had imagined the end. The gurgling of water, a deafening heartbeat. But then, returned Ember's good deed by leading them to a lost forlorn. The stranger stood alone. Their friends have fallen aside, retreating from what came next. The stranger had ventured on. Now they were deep in the woods. Pointless. The stranger spoke hesitantly. Is the campfire crowded? Let me gather myself. I'll see you there. If you need help catching anything, you just ask. The fisherman noticed the broken net Ember was carrying. Let me have a look. See what, with a silk thread, the fisherman, with each knot he tied, a net began. Here you go. Good as new. He was nestled between the reeds, but it was just out of reach. The old gate was locked. Ember placed the key in the lock and slowly began to turn it. Stranger gasped for breath. Dark water slipping above their head. The sea didn't care if they sank or swam. Slowly the tides ebbed, washing over old walls. Harbor emerging from the inky depths. Ember reached out a hand. Thank you. stranger look down. The ground feels good beneath my feet, friend. The ghost said, "You have done all you can, little one. Your journey lies ahead. Little one, your journey ahead will not be easy. The path to leave this place is blocked. I will guide others to follow after you clear the way." There are others like me who can help. You will always be welcome here in the forest. Once again, Ember could feel eyes watching.